The next presentation is poster number 81, a preliminary study of the local effectiveness of the locally composed receptive music medicine on short-term symptomatic relief of the Sri Lankan patients with mild to moderate depression. The authors are Herat HMSA, Hewage SHJB, Horadugoda HGDH, Virathunga PM, Pereira M, and Fernando TH. The presenting author, the Herat HMSA.
Good afternoon, everybody, and thank you very much for giving me this opportunity. So we all know that depression is a major cause of morbidity, and also it causes a huge loss of functional limitation. So when we compare Sri Lanka, being a developing country, we all know that it causes a huge health cost as well as loss of productive life years. So there is a paucity of knowledge in music medicine as a therapeutic option in treating depression. So we had this objective to determine the effectiveness of music medicine on short-term symptomatic relief of Sri Lankan patients with mild to moderate depression. And to the best of our knowledge, this is the first clinical trial done in Sri Lanka and the region which try out music medicine as a therapeutic option. So our study was done in outpatient psychiatric clinic at NHSL, which included 41 participants newly diagnosed with mild to moderate depression using ICD-10. And it was a randomized, single blinded interventional study. And there was a control group and an experimental group. For the control group, they received the standard care alone, but the experimental group received the standard care in and the music medicine that we composed. A little bit of a brief about the music that was locally composed. It lasted about 15 minutes, and it included 6 sessions, gradually lifting up the mood of the patient. And it was composed within a multidisciplinary collaboration, which included psychiatrists, medical students, musicians, and students from the visual and performing arts also. So they had to listen 6 times per week for a 4 weeks duration. And the assessment was done pre-interventional and post-interventional using the Beck Depression Inventory. At the end point, experimental group also received a questionnaire to assess the cofactors which would have influenced the outcome. Regarding the results, there were no significant baseline differences in the age, the mean score of BDI, and the gender or the drug consumption. At the end of the study, the control group had an improvement in the BDI score of 6.81, and the experimental group had a significant improvement of 15.15, which was less than 0.01 significance, which was assessed using the independent sample t-test. And there were no significance in other socio-demographic factors, music preference, and familiarity to the music, and the family support, and the academic knowledge on music or the drug consumption. But when compared the subgroup analysis on the mild and moderate depression categories, there was a improvement of 21 mean improvement in BDI score, which was again significant, less than 0.01. So we can conclude that in addition to the standard care, music medicine is an effective therapeutic modality in treating mild to moderate depression. Thank you.
Thank you. The paper is open for discussion.
How much of contribution does this particular research makes to this literature on entrainment?
Sorry?
Literature on entrainment, that where they use mononeural and binaural waves to adjust brain waves so that, you know, they are basically the EEG patterns can be altered,
yeah,
using those kind of things. Did you get any input from it, or are you contributing?
Yeah, for that thing, I think we need to get down patients in interacting with the face to face. So, but this was delivered as a music medicine, the patients were given the piece of music via CDs or mobile phones to listen, and we had a follow up, and at the end of the in the next clinic visit we assessed again.
So how much is this locally composed music has an effect? Can it be like the music that is already available, like
when we were referring to the literature, there were no any recommended music available for treating depression as a therapeutic modality. So, and also in the Sri Lanka and the region also, there were no any locally composed. So we could compose something that was with cultural adaptations to our country using the many musicians and the within this multidisciplinary collaboration.
But can it act the other way around also? Like, can music, not medicine then, the music that they listen to in wards or any other place, can it have a negative impact on the stressors and the psychological status?
We should assess that.
Yeah. Okay.
Thank you.
Right, thank you.
Thank you. Let's give a round of applause to the presenter.